Black Plague, a time of disease, pestilence, and death. It decimated medieval Europe, killing millions of people. What caused this devastating epidemic? And how did it infect so many people? This is your body on the Black Death Plague.
I'm not dead.
What? Nothing. Here's your nine pence.
I'm not dead.
In October of 1347, 12 ships arrived in Messina from the Black Sea. Most of the sailors were dead. The rest were very sick and covered in black boils. They were infected with the plague. Within 5 years, 20 million people were dead. One-third of the European population. But this wasn't the first instance of what Europeans referred to as the Great Pestilence. It had already appeared in China, India, and Egypt. It may have existed in Europe as early as 3000 BCE. While this is all ancient history, could the Black Plague affect us today? And if it did, what would happen to your body? The Black Plague is spread by the bacillus bacteria Yersinia pestis. It can spread through the air or in the bite of infected fleas or rats. A plague can take on different forms, including septicemic, pneumonic, and bubonic. If you get the bubonic plague, you'll have extreme weakness, headache, and swollen and painful lymph nodes. A flea bite has likely infected you. Symptoms of septicemic plague include fever, abdominal pain, and bleeding. Your skin may turn black and die. You can get it from an infected flea or the handling of infected animals. If you have the pneumonic plague, you could suffer from headaches, shortness of breath, and bloody or watery mucus. You can get this from inhaling infected droplets or by plague bacteria spreading to your lungs. Pneumonic is the most serious form of the plague and will lead to respiratory failure. The concept of quarantine was devised as a way to prevent the spread of the plague.
Quarantine.
In the Venetian-controlled city of Ragusa, newly arrived sailors were kept in isolation for 40 days to ensure they weren't sick. In Italian, 40 is
40.
And this isolation was called a quarantino. The practice was so successful that the Western world soon started using it. During the Middle Ages, treatment for the plague was almost non-existent. Many doctors refused to treat the plague-stricken, and if you could get treatment, it would likely include bloodletting and boil lancing. Some treatments were more superstitious, like burning aromatic herbs or bathing in rose water. Desperate people tried to escape the plague by moving out of cities and into the country. However, the pathogen also affected livestock and could be passed by contact. There was even a shortage of wool because so many sheep died. Although many of us think of Black Death as a medieval disease or even a heavy metal band, the plague still exists.
I don't believe it.
There are 1 to 3,000 cases every year. Most are in Africa, India, and Peru. Surprisingly, there are a few cases in the southwest United States where wild rodents carry the bacteria. 80% of U.S. cases are of bubonic plague. If you were infected, you would need immediate attention before the bacteria entered your bloodstream or lungs. The good news is medicine has come a long way since the Middle Ages. And our doctors aren't nearly as scary looking. The plague can be successfully treated with antibiotics, especially within the first 24 hours of symptoms. Without treatment, the death rate is up to 60%. With antibiotics, that drops to 11%. If you are at a high risk of exposure, don't worry. A vaccine can reduce the incidence and severity of symptoms if an infected flea bites you. Okay, now that you've survived the plague, let's find out what happens when you get rabies. We'll explore that on another episode of Your Body On.